Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you guys how I took this wig from Dola Hair in its natural state with this black color and how I transformed it to this more cinnamon, honey brown kind of color. So if you are interested, please stay tuned. All right, before we get into the process, I wanted to tell you guys, I did dye this wig once before off camera, and that's why you see this chocolate brown color. And I used just like one bottle of the Loreal high color. I think it was in the coolest light brown, but it wasn't like bright enough for me. Like in certain lighting, you could even tell that, you know, color was on the hair. So what I did was I went back to Sally's and I got the L'Oreal high color in H2 and H1, and I'll have everything listed below. And I got my developer, 40 volume developer, and I mixed both containers in my mixing bowl. And I just whipped it up in my mixing bowl, and then I just poured it on the hair. I didn't have, like, I was pretty sloppy with it. I was gonna paint it on first, and you'll see me do that, but then eventually I just poured it all over the hair and I worked it through on the top, in between, underneath, and I even got most of it on the roots as well. If you don't want your roots to be like that honey brown cinnamon color, then, you know, leave about an inch of space once you get to the root. So I put the dye on the wig, and then I actually wrapped it up in aluminum foil, and it stayed wrapped up for about 2.5-3 hours. And I know that's long, but I really wanted the color to lift and, you know, be a big transformation. So the hair didn't get like messed up or fried. It still turned out really beautiful. So that's how I achieved like the base color. What I don't have on camera is the little like blonde highlights in it. And all I did for the blonde highlights was take some powder bleach and 40 volume developer. And while I was bleaching the knots on this wig, I just slapped some highlights in it. Like super easy. I just did that on a whim. So that's why I didn't record it. And that's how this color came out. All right, so I have my, I said I wasn't gonna do the stocking cap method anymore, but I'm gonna try again today because this is the only wig I'm reviewing today. And so I just cut off the excess lace, and I still have like some frayed areas around the edge. So I'm gonna take this 3-in-1 edge brush that I picked up from the beauty supply store recently. So it has the brush end for your edges, and then like the comb part, and then it has this flat part at the bottom here. And I think it is for like lace application. I'm just gonna go around my edges with the black bottle of Got to Be Glued. And I'm just gonna lay down all those areas that are still kind of sticking up just a little bit. All right, so I just put some curls in this wig using my, I think it's 1.5 inch curl wand, and they're just like some loose curls. But I feel like this color turned out very beautiful. I feel like it's very, you know, fall appropriate and everything. So if you are interested in trying this out, it's very easy. I wouldn't try to do it all in one day. You probably could if you had the time, but I think it's very beautiful. All you have to do is do like the cinnamon color first, let that dry. And then for the highlights, you know, go in once it's dry the next day and mix up your developer and powder bleach and just put some highlights in it. And it definitely adds some dimension. So I want to thank Dola Hair for sending me this wig to review for you guys. And the hair is holding up pretty well, even with, you know, that intense process of bleaching the of bleaching the wig, it still feels very nice and soft. So if you are interested in this hair, head over to Dola Hair and pick it up there. Check out the original review and make sure you are subscribed and follow me on all of my social media platforms. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye, guys.